Hey guys, I hope you're ready for 2 days of extreme cleaning. On day one, it was at nighttime. My kids were in bed and I wanted to get the house picked up and cleaned up, wipe things down, vacuum and mop before waking up the next day and really having a very motivating, successful day of cleaning. And it will be on day two that I'm going to be deep cleaning outside. And if you want some satisfying cleaning, you're definitely going to see it on day two. I bust out my power washer. I deep clean the outside windows. I used the power washer on our patio. I also cleaned our patio furniture, basically getting things ready for the winter. So stay tuned. We have a lot we're going to be doing and a lot of satisfying cleaning. If you've never been to my channel before, I am Jamie. I'm sure you already knew that, but I'm married to my husband, Mike, who is my high school sweetheart. He works in finance. He's a financial analyst, and we have three daughters. My oldest is a five-year-old, and then I have twins who are 18 months. And I documented my infertility journey here on YouTube because we had to go through IVF to get pregnant with the twins. So we are grateful and very thankful for our entire family. Every week I put out videos here on my channel, and hopefully you guys will come and be a part of my community. We can be friends, we can help motivate each other. And my goal is to build a community where we can all support and uplift each other. So I would love to have you subscribe and join my journey. My goal is to give you guys cleaning tips and hacks, show organization ideas, and just mom life in general. I will have a Get to Know Me playlist linked in the description where you can get to know me a little bit better. But if you are new, please say hi in the comment section. I read every comment. I respond to your comments because you guys mean the world to me. So make sure you say hi, and I would love to have you join my journey.
Here's what I like, laying on the beach with sunlight in my eyes, laughing with my friends under the sky. Following our hearts, so then we take a ride wherever. I always try to let my spirit fly.
So I've already started making a list of videos that I want to do in the new year. That's usually when I get that bug to start organizing, and I have a long list of organization videos that I want to do. I'm also going to be trying out some new cleaning products that I've seen. So all of this, of course, I will be sharing with you guys, so stay tuned. To wipe down my countertops, I'm using the JAWS, which stands for Just Add Water Systems. So you reuse the bottles and you just buy new pods. But I'm using their granite cleaner. It's one of my go-tos for my countertops, and it smells really good and it does a really good job of cleaning. And you will see me using the JAWS cleaning products all over my house. But if you guys are new, I live in Northern Ohio, and at this point in the year, it's getting pretty cold outside. So what I had planned for the next day when I woke up was to clean outside and prepare our outside for the winter. So I wanted to clean our patio furniture, which had some chocolate and marshmallow on it from those summer nights when we were around the fire eating s'mores. So I wanted to give the patio furniture a good cleaning. I wanted to power wash the patio. We had a lot of leaves and a bunch of stuff that had blown on there. So that was my plan for the next day. So you're going to see me do a lot more deep cleaning before the winter weather arrives tomorrow morning. If you guys don't follow me on Instagram, then you may not know, but it has been quite the week for our family. Emery, which is actually my youngest child, one of my twins, had something growing under her eye about 3 weeks ago. We saw a pediatrician and they thought it was a hemangioma. So we had plans to see a specialist, but on Monday night, it burst open in the middle of the night and there was blood everywhere. You guys know that the face and the head is a very vascular area, so it just bled all over. It was kind of scary to see that in the middle of the night, but we were able to get the bleeding to stop. But then it happened again during nap time on Tuesday, and then on Tuesday night, middle of the night, it actually ripped off and blood again was everywhere. So we could not get the bleeding to stop at that point. We took her to the ER. We saw four different doctors this week, and eventually on Friday we saw a pediatric dermatologist, and they had diagnosed her with a pyogenic granuloma, which is not serious, so that is wonderful. And they ended up, they said usually they scrape it off and then they cauterize the area to stop the bleeding. Well, they didn't need to scrape it off because it already fell off, so they cauterized the area to stop the bleeding because it started bleeding again in the office. And we're hoping that now that'll take care of it and it will heal over. But if not, maybe in a week or two, we will know more and we will have to go see a plastic surgeon and figure something else out. So it has been quite the week. A lot of cleaning, a lot of blood, a lot of laundry, a lot of sleepless nights, but we're doing pretty good. We've got this conversation and you seem to agree with me. But when there's complications, you withdraw and leave me to be. Problem, you become like a wall, and every time I trip, it's a free fall. Why don't you help me the way I help you? You don't have to save me, just be my parachute. When I'm feeling down, you're just not there. So this was on day two of cleaning. The twins were actually taking a morning nap. At this point, at 18 months, they have dropped their morning nap. They just take a long 3-hour afternoon nap, but because of the crazy week that we had going on, lack of sleep, they needed a morning nap. So they were napping, and as you can see, Avery was still in her pajamas, her Elsa Frozen nightgown, and Mike and I got to work because the twins were down for their nap and we had the time. And I wanted to remove the rug outside, use my power washer, clean up the patio, hose off some of the chalk, and get everything cleaned up before the cold weather gets here. I will also have the power washer linked down below if you guys want to check it out, but it makes cleaning so much easier because it just takes care of the cleaning without much scrubbing or soap or anything like that. It's a free fall. I also wanted to clean the water table and the girls' picnic table. We will take that inside to the garage just so it doesn't get covered with snow. And we obviously won't be using it all winter long, so I wanted to make sure I was cleaning it. So right now here in October, I would say that October tends to be a pretty weather changing month for us. So the weather starts out pretty mild in October. We even had some 70 degree days here in October, but usually by Halloween, it's pretty cold. So I would say, like, when I think back to past years, some Halloweens it's snowing. We've had freezing rain. I know before we had kids, when we were handing out candy, we've had a heater on the front porch and gloves and hats and winter coats. And then other times, I feel like the past 2 years, it's been kind of warm as far as Halloween goes for us here in Northern Ohio. So we just had like on a heavier fleece coat and it wasn't too bad. So, you know, like I said, October is really the changing month as far as fall goes. Starts out pretty mild and then gets pretty cold by the end of the month. And then we usually get our first measurable snowfall by mid-November. So it's coming. It's coming for us. And we usually will have snow through March. So to clean the water table and the picnic table, I just squirted some Dawn dish soap on there and then power washed it. I've cleaned these before and I just used the power washer, which does take care of the dirt, but I figured I wanted to add a little bit of soap for some extra cleaning power since we were taking these inside for the winter. And then the next step on my list was the patio furniture cushions. And like I told you before, we had marshmallows and chocolate on here, which I'll point out to you in a minute. And I've never cleaned these, so I really wanted to take care of that today. And the plan was just to use the power washer to remove anything that was on the cushions. And this power washer just makes cleaning so much easier. No deep scrubbing or anything. Okay, I don't know if the camera is picking this up, but there's some small stains on here. So I'm gonna see if the power washer will get that up alone or if I'm gonna have to get some soap and scrub it. And I know on one of these, I don't know which one it is. I don't think I saw it here, but there was some chocolate stains from the kids when we had s'mores one time this summer. So I'm gonna try to see if the power washer will take care of most of those stains, and if not, I'll scrub them with a little bit of Dawn. It took care of all of the stains, at least on this cushion, so pretty impressive. Makes it so much easier than scrubbing, but we'll turn these over and see if there's any more stains. Stain. There we go. There's our more stain. So we'll see what the power washer can do for that. but it took it all off. So there's some more here that I'll go for. And then I think, something I didn't anticipate, I'm gonna have to move these back to the patio and probably hose them back off because I'm getting grass all over them. But I was gonna do the actual furniture anyways once we got that back on the concrete and the patio. So I'll just go give these another hose down before they dry. I'm not a bad mom, I promise. But while I was cleaning the cushions, Avery came over and started to draw on the patio with chalk. But she did it not because she was just being an artist, but because she wanted to see me hose it off. She thinks it looks really cool when I hose off the chalk. So I'm not being a mean mom and erasing Avery's beautiful drawings. But once I hosed off the patio again, Mike and I put the patio furniture back together. And I gave it one more hose down, and then I was going to clean the windows from the outside. I got this weight on my shoulders, slowing me down. I don't know how it came about. And while the world is spinning faster every night, I feel I'm stuck in reverse somehow. But it ain't no one's fault that I am stuck here. So this is one of my most asked about cleaning tools. I got it from Lowe's, but I'll have it linked down below. It just makes cleaning the windows so much easier and kind of fun. So if you look closely, you can see one side where I can scrub the windows, and then the other has a squeegee on it, which allows me to squeegee the windows when I'm done. But in my bucket of water to clean the windows, I just use Dawn and water, and that leaves the windows looking pretty clean and shiny. I gotta pull it together before it's too late. An hourglass in my mind alight. I know it's all my fault that I am stuck here. No one to blame this on, feeling so hopeless. I gotta find a way before it disappears. I cannot stay. I feel the pressure on me. How it's itching. So as I said, we are getting the outside ready for the winter, which means the holidays are fastly approaching, and it's going to be here before we know it. And again, my kids are 5 and 18 months, and if you have kids around that age, maybe grandchildren or nieces, let me know what you're getting them for Christmas. And I'll be honest with you, we don't have plans to get the twins a lot. You know, they don't even know what Christmas is. Who Santa is, and of course we will get them things, but we saved all of the toys that Avery was when she was their age, so they have all of the typical 18 month old girl toys, so we don't want to just buy them more, so we don't have plans on buying them a lot more of things that they will need, probably more practical things. But honestly, for Avery, I'm a little stumped this year, so if you have a 5-year-old or a 6-year-old girl, let me know what you plan on getting them for Christmas.
So I
pretty sure the plan for when I edit this video is to give you guys a background of everything that we've been going on this week and how crazy this week has been. So at this point, I'm thinking you already know the full story, and I just didn't want to sit here and talk about it here and eat up time. But it's just been a long week, and I want to thank you all for your well wishes and your prayers, sending it all to Emery. It really means a lot to me. I don't take it for granted. So thank you guys so much for all of your messages here on YouTube and then over on Instagram. But it's been a long week. I'm a little tired, but I wanted to get the house cleaned up. You guys know that cleaning is like therapy for me. I really do. I don't want to say like I actually love the cleaning part. I don't mind it, but what I love so much and where I feel calm and relaxed and I feel less anxiety is when my house is clean. And obviously with the week that we've had, the house has been a disaster. I've barely cleaned. So it just feels nice that now that the week is over with, things are settling down, I can kind of get things cleaned up, and it's kind of like me decompressing after the long week. So thank you for your prayers. As tired as I am, it really feels good to kind of get my house back in order, and it makes me feel really, really good. So I'm gonna continue on today, get some more cleaning done while Mike is hanging with the girls. So yeah, I'm gonna try to get it done today, and I'm ready to get this house.
It was a Thursday night when I first saw you. Those green eyes caught me. Yeah.
So ever since we put a storm door, I think that's what you call it, like a door between our main door and the outside. Does that make sense? Where we can keep the door open. We've been using this front area way more. We used to use our garage more frequently, but now we use our front door because usually the front or the actual door is open and we just leave the storm door where we can see out, especially with Avery going to the bus every morning. We, you know, walk her out to the bus, pick her up from the bus stop. We use this door way more frequently, and I feel like this area gets beat up, so I like to wipe it down frequently, like the baseboards and the door, just so I can, you know, stay on top of it. Okay, so I know this wasn't a ton, but I did vacuum the stairs last week. It's not a lot that came out of there, but when you look at it, you're like, all of that was just sitting in the carpet as we walked, what, how many times up and down those stairs? So, pretty satisfying to always see what comes out of the area that you're vacuuming.
Everything has changed every day. 24/7, you call my name.
So after I vacuumed the stairs, I went into the laundry room, and we've been using this laundry room a ton this week with all of the bloody clothes and bloody sheets and everything. So I wanted to give the laundry room a good deep cleaning. So I wiped everything down in here, and then I was going to clean the floors. And when I clean the floors, I vacuum, which is super important because this is where we keep the cat's litter box and the dog's food. So there's always a lot to vacuum up. And then I was gonna clean my grout using my Resolve foaming carpet cleaner. And I get asked about this all of the time, but it is foaming carpet cleaner. I get it from Walmart, Target, but I've been getting a lot of you guys telling me that you haven't been able to find it lately, and I haven't had to buy it. So I just hope they're still selling it. But you just spray it on your grout and it whitens and cleans the grout itself with very minimal scrubbing. And then the plan for the rest of this day was to clean up the rest of the upstairs. Like I said, everything was kind of put on the back burner this entire week, and I just wanted to get things at least picked up. Nothing too crazy, but just get things picked up and vacuuming. Like I said, it had been a long week, but honestly, it was okay. And I was grateful all week long because I knew deep down that Emery would be okay. You know, it's like you get down and it's not ideal that we lost sleep 3 nights in a row, that Emery bled a lot, that we had to go to the ER, that she was, you know, that we had a lot on our plate, and it was a very stressful week dealing with, you know, not just her, but then 2 other kids and working and all of that on top of that. So it was stressful, but sometimes in those really stressful times, you have to look at the positives. And I know that's not always easy. I don't really consider myself a positive person. I tend to be more pessimistic, honestly. However, in those really tough times, I will look at, you know, yeah, we're in the ER, but she's fine. You know, we could be in the ER because it could be way more serious, or she could be hospitalized or something like that. So those type of things are what gets me through when I have really tough times. So to wipe down my bathrooms, I'm using the Jaws foaming bathroom cleaner. If you guys want to try out Jaws, I know I say this in every video, but you never know, like if you guys are new or you don't hear it before, but you can try it out and use my coupon code for 20% off. I don't make anything from the sale of the products. So if you purchase them, I'm just sharing it with you because I do think they're great products. They have a disinfectant. They have a foaming bathroom cleaner. They have a kitchen degreaser, which you saw me use earlier in the video. So one of my favorite overall cleaning brands. I still love the Mrs. Meyer's Grove Collaborative products. I don't think I'll ever give up their multi-surface spray, that, you know, the multi-surface spray that's scented. I usually get one for every season, and then I use the lavender one here upstairs, but I thoroughly enjoy the Jaws cleaning products as well as e-cloths. You can see me using the e-cloth mop here. You just have to wet the mop with water and then you can use the mop, and you can read all about it in the description. If you're like, wait a minute, cleaning with water, what? But I like keeping this mop upstairs because I don't know. I feel like sometimes one of my biggest issues with not getting cleaning done is cleaning hurdles. So if I can eliminate those hurdles, so having easy access to cleaning products or a mop, you know, I'm much more likely to mop if all I have to do is take the mop head, run it underwater and stick it. It just Velcros right on the mop and then I can mop really quickly, you know? So I don't have to fill up a bucket. I don't have to plug in anything. Like, I know that sounds really lazy, but I'm sure you guys all know what I'm talking about. So eliminating hurdles makes me more likely to keep up with my cleaning. And yeah, that's why I love this mop for upstairs. Are there any cleaning products you guys would like to see me try out? Have you heard of anything? Do you want to see how something works? If you're curious about a specific cleaning product, let me know. I can try them out for you as long as I can find them in the store. I know it's not always easy to find cleaning products these days, but I truly appreciate you guys, you know, keeping me in the loop of any cleaning products, and I'm always willing to try them out for you because, hey, you never know. Sometimes I get in a rut of just using the same products over and over. So let me know if you have any cleaning products. Right now. I'm gonna be completely honest with you guys. As I'm cleaning, I still feel like I wanna get my house cleaned up because, again, it makes me feel calm and just more, I guess, in control because we've had a lot of things out of our control this week. I am just not fully feeling it. I'm still gonna be cleaning up the rest of the upstairs, but just more like picking up and basic wiping down. I had plans on doing some more deep cleaning up here just because I had the time since Avery is with her grandparents at a pumpkin patch and Mike is hanging with the twins. Also, they were napping part of this afternoon. So I had the time, I wanted to do it, but I just don't have it in me to continue. So just more of like a basic clean for the rest of the upstairs, which is totally fine. I know I have to give myself some grace, and even though I want to do more deep cleaning, just not feeling it today. So I thought I would just be completely honest with you. I think it's hard for me sometimes to share, you know I don't always share my true feelings here on YouTube, but to be completely honest with you, I'm just not feeling it. And these are the times where I have to take my, I tend to be a perfectionist when it comes to cleaning, or not a perfectionist, you know that I take cleaning shortcuts, but like when I have my mind set on things that I want to get done and accomplished, I always get it accomplished. That's how I am. Like I make my list and I knock it out, and I'm just not feeling it today. So I'm gonna give myself some grace, just get the basics done, and then relax for the rest of the night.
I might be going crazy, I don't know what to do. My heart is screaming for you.
So here in our bathroom, I was just clearing the countertop. I was going to wipe things down like the mirrors and the vanity and then do kind of the same thing that I did in the girls' bathroom, was vacuum and mop. And it's super important that I always at least vacuum in our bathroom because of the hair. I don't wash my hair as frequently as I used to. I actually only wash my hair once a week. I've trained my hair. So if you guys are like, what? How did you do that? I have oily, greasy hair. I promise you, I have a very oily, greasy face, oily skin, but I trained my hair. I used to wash it every day, and then slowly, like over like 3 or 4 years, I went from washing it every day until every other day, and then so on. And I just slowly over time would stretch it out, and now I wash it once a week. So I don't shed as much because I feel like drying my hair with a hair dryer and brushing it out when it's wet, that's when I tend to lose the most hair, but I still lose a decent amount. So vacuuming in here is essential.
Glowing in the dark, I feel it in my heart. You're glowing in the dark, glowing in the dark. Yeah, you're glowing in the dark.
Oh, and don't forget to come over and find me on Instagram.
You're growing in the dark. You're growing in the dark. Growing in the dark. Growing in my heart. You're growing in the dark. Growing in the dark. Yeah, you're growing in the dark. You can make it go away. Growing in the dark. You can make it go away. You're growing in the dark.
Okay, so I brought this into the bathroom because there's better lighting in here, but this is just from up here. Completely full. I'm gonna go ahead and end it here. Emery is napping, but if you hold on 1 second, I'll get a cute clip of her later when she wakes up so you guys can say hi to her. But thank you so much for sticking around. You guys are amazing. Thank you. I can't
there's just so much meaning behind that word, and thank you probably isn't enough. But would love to have you guys subscribe if you're new, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.
Oh, the goal is she had it cauterized. Oh, are you saying hi? And we're hoping that takes care of it. If not, like I said, topical beta blocker or plastic surgeon. That would be the probably.